At the Nanjing Rowing and Canoeing School, it was finals day of the canoe and kayak obstacle slalom. The athletes race against each other. It all starts from a raised ramp. There are obstacles to negotiate, and then at the bottom of the course, an Eskimo roll. And then paddle back up through the course. Starting with the C1 bronze medal race for the women. Balancing on the ramp, ready to go, was Lucie Priou from France and Brigitte O'Meyer of Germany, wearing number 27. It was a very exciting race, nothing separated them. On the line, it was O'Meyer who just snatched the bronze medal. So then, in the gold medal race, from the Czech Republic, Martina Saltkova set off against Nadine Varachnik of Austria. They swiftly negotiated the obstacles. Then the Austrian, wearing number 3, began to pull away, and she crossed the line with around 3 seconds to spare, in gold medal position. Gold to Austria, silver to the Czech Republic, and bronze went to Germany.
It was a great race. It was a very hard race, and in the end, all in all, it was perfect. This medal, it's the greatest success I've ever had, so it's the best.
The men's C1 bronze medal race was between Leon Breznik of Slovenia and Marko Mirgorodski from Slovakia. Wearing number 59, Mirgorodski delivered a dominant performance, winning bronze by 5 seconds. Then the gold medal race. It was contested by Robert Hendrick of Ireland and Lucas Rochan from France. This was a close race, but Rochan, closest to us, powered through the course and grabbed the gold by only a second. So it was gold for France, silver went to Ireland and bronze to Slovakia.
I would like to thank my family and my friends for I dedicate this medal to my father because it's my training man all of the years.
On to the women's K1 bronze medal showdown. It was between Selina Jones from Germany and Amelie Hilgertova from the Czech Republic. And wearing number 14, she glided to bronze medal victory. In the gold medal contest, there was a very close finish and an exciting race. Camille Prigent of France, nearest us, set off against Jinghua Yan from China. The crowd seemed to enjoy this race, and it remained close right up to the line when Prigent just edged the victory. So gold went to France, silver to China, and the bronze to the Czech Republic.
The Chinese girl was really great too, and during my race I didn't see where she was. So I was, no, I'm first, I'm two, I don't know. So I did my best and it was okay.
What does this medal mean to you?
It means a lot for me because my aunt, she has 2 gold medals from Olympics. So for me it's, I know it's just Youth Olympic Games, but for me it's just an amazing feeling. It's great.
Then to the men's K1 bronze medal race. This encounter had the home crowd also on their feet as China's Song Huang took to the water against Paul Sunderland from Great Britain. Wearing number 9, Huang just managed to stay in front through the course and he grabbed the bronze medal place with little to spare. In the K1 gold medal race, it was another Slovakia versus Slovenia contest. Would the result be different this time? Anza Oranka from Slovenia managed to keep his boat in front as Jacob Grigor hung on. In the end, 2 seconds separated them on the line, and this time it was gold for Slovenia. So Slovenia took gold, Slovakia silver, and China the bronze.
I don't know, I have mixed feelings. I wanted to win, as everyone here, but I'm happy. Medal is medal. I'm silver, so that's pretty important for me.